Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Amar Chikneri and I represent the partner ecosystem for India business for Enterprise DB. And just to introduce ourselves, Enterprise DB is a principal organization which supports engineers, services and trains people on Postgres database. So Postgres, as many of you would be aware, is an open source RDBMS project, one of the most mature open source projects rather, which is there in existence for last almost 20 to 22 years, right? So the key message of my quick presentation here is going to be, how do you transform your existing database management system into something which is more cost effective and something which is long term benefit to you in order to fuel investments for your innovation, customer innovation or customer engagement kind of applications. Because all of us these days are talking about social media, mobility, and there is definitely a money which goes into building these apps or even deploying these apps, and where do you find that money is what my messaging is going to be about. So this is a, you know, we have seen this popular advertisement coming on the TV all the time that I think Irfan Khan does this advertisement of shifting to an LED, a Cisco LED, right? So it's quite similar to this in terms of, you know, you are actually trying to change your IT lights for a reason, because keeping these IT lights switched on for a long duration is costing you a heavy money. The way you are, probably you will burn your electricity bill if you continuously switch on expensive bulbs. Similarly, your IT bulbs need a change also, right? So you need to shift to something which is a completely cost effective option, and keeping the existing commercial and I would say, rather than saying commercial, proprietary IT infrastructure lights on is costing a lot of CIOs and CFOs a lot of money, right? Now, is it really costing us the future? Let's find out. So basically, in an infrastructure, typically all of us know the major components of the infrastructure: operating system, middleware, database, and then the app stack is there. And then at a further higher level, we talk about business intelligence, analytics, cloud, mobility, and, you know, rest of the stuff. In order to get money for this, how do we actually structure it in a way that we know how much we are going to save? So if you see, Gartner has published a report in which they have said that out of the total IT infrastructure budget spent which happens for any enterprise, 35% of that is for the database management system. It's a huge money actually. It's more than one third money which you allocate to your total IT infrastructure. Let's say you're running a app like, you know, maybe Make My Trip, or even, you know, you're running an app like social networking app, or you are running something which is an enterprise class app, ERP, right? The infrastructure which you associate with this, 30%, 35% of it is consumed by the databases. This is a famous finding from a Gartner report. Out of these databases, almost 80% in-house applications, which are built by your own IT team, or which are built by a smaller partner community, or which are built on open source, and which are friendly with working with many infrastructure choices, 80% of those are very good candidates to move off to a cheaper and a reasonable database management system, but we haven't done that. So we are actually locking in money in 80% of those DBMS. And then the cost savings, if you see, so what we have done is, over these years, we started our presence in India in 2009. Our global presence started back in 2005. Postgres has been there for a while. And what Postgres has been doing and Enterprise DB has been doing is, we are actually making customer realize cost savings up to 70%, which is a huge, I'm not talking about, you know, probably 20%, 25%, 30%. I'm talking about 70% of the cost savings of a total cost of ownership, right? Now, how this happens basically? So the message, as I said, that the more amount of money you spent from your revenue on a single infrastructure component, less is going to be the money which is going to be available for your other, you know, applications which are responsible for customer innovation or customer engagement. So these apps can be, you know, customer experience management apps, customer relationship management apps, probably social mobility apps. But, you know, if you don't have any money left for these apps because you are spending money somewhere else, obviously your customer engagement is going to reduce, right? So I'm sure this forum consists of a lot of startups, a lot of open source enthusiasts who would want to create that next, maybe next Twitter or next Facebook or next Make My Trip or next Flipkart for that matter. And it is an extremely important choice to make at the starting point itself. Now, this is the stack I was talking about, right? So, in terms of commoditizing, or rationalizing for stability, this part, operating system, virtual machine, and to an extent middleware also, it's kind of matured now. So, all of us are aware about what Fedora was, what Red Hat is, and, perhaps we are aware about, the choices for WebLogic and WebSphere, or, JBoss for that matter, Red Hat. We are quite well accustomed with the benefits these stacks have given us. But what is the maximum impacting component? This is the maximum impacting component, as I have been saying. So, if we replace this component itself and put the money which gets released into these things, which are actually high value investments for an enterprise, then it makes sense. Then it makes a lot of sense, right? This is just a trend which has been captured from 2009 to 2015. Now, this comparison, I'm not taking any specific names out here, but if you see, this grid represents the maturity or, how successful a particular DBMS is in terms of four or five characteristics. So, right from availability of the skills in the market to how they can drive mission critical application success and to total cost of ownership, which is the most important point. This grid in 2009 looked like this. So, this blue part, this represents a typical commercial or a proprietary kind of a database software. And this is the orange line, which actually represents the open source DBMS stack, right? As you see the comparison and we move from 2009 to 2015, this is where we have reached. So, right in terms of a total cost of ownership benefit to DBA tools and availability of the skills and the resources, we have almost reached a stage where any proprietary database would place themselves into. So, there is a big change which is taking place in the market, and I think all the companies who are in the starting years of their growth or even maturity of their growth should actually take benefit from this trend, which is clearly demonstrated. So, just to give you a quick perspective on what Enterprise DB is, all of us are aware that we would like to rely as much as on open source tools, open source products like Postgres. However, in terms of actually deploying a mission critical application, we need assurance. Assurance in terms of whether we have right skills to monitor and maintain the databases, whether we get the warranties and indemnifications in place, whether we get the right support system in place. So, companies like Enterprise DB or companies which operate under a umbrella of supported open source play a very critical role of combining innovation of open source on one side and giving a reliability or a peace of mind, enterprise reliability on another side. So, I wouldn't want to speak much about my organization here, but organizations like us, Enterprise DB, actually give you a beautiful combination of innovation and reliability on both sides. So, in terms of what is the most critical factor when you have already deployed a lot of your IT lights or a lot of your IT applications on a commercial or a proprietary RDBMS, it is important for us to